Hello guys, in this video we are going to compare KTM recently launched RC 125 with Yamaha R15 V3. Since both the bikes are sports bikes having a dedicated sitting position, also the price is in the comparable range. So I thought of making a video on its comparison to make out which one is better for you. KTM and Yamaha both have made decent brand value and you can trust these two bikes without any second thought. The engine refinement, build quality, paint quality used are top notch. So what we are going to cover in this video? First we are going to cover the technical differences between the bikes. And second we are going to cover the riding comfort, price and mileage of these two bikes. So let's get started. RC 125 has twin projector headlamp, whereas R15 V3 has normal LED headlamp. Here the light focus will be much better in RC 125 compared to R15 V3. R15 V3 has delta box frame, whereas RC 125 has trellis frame. R15 V3 has a seat height of 815 mm, whereas RC 125 has a seat height of 835 mm. So you can expect slight discomfort to the pillion rider in RC 125. R15 V3 has a fuel tank capacity of 11 liters, which is quite good for the long rides, but RC 125 has the fuel tank of 9.5 liters. Now here comes the major difference. RC 125 has single channel Bosch ABS, that means ABS is operational on the front wheel. Whereas R15 V3 has dual channel ABS, which means ABS is operational on both the wheels. Both the bikes have dual disc brakes. If we talk about KTM RC 125, it has front brake of 300 mm, whereas rear brake of 230 mm. R15 V3 has front brake of 282 mm, whereas rear brake of 220 mm. Another major difference is the ground clearance. RC 125 has ground clearance of 157 mm, which is quite less considering the Indian road conditions. R15 V3 has much better ground clearance, which is 170 mm. Now comes the main difference, which is the engine. KTM RC has single cylinder 124.7cc liquid cooled DOHC engine, which produces about 14.5 PS of power at 9250 rpm and 12 Nm of torque at 8000 rpm. RC 125 is a fuel injected bike having 6-speed gearbox. If we talk about the engine of R15 V3, it has single cylinder 155.1cc liquid cool SOHC engine, which produces about 19.3 PS of power at 10000 rpm and maximum torque of 14.7 Nm at the rate 8500 rpm. R15 V3 is also a fuel injected bike having 6-speed gearbox. Since R15 V3 is a higher cc bike, the top speed of the bike is around 135 to 140 km per hour, whereas from RC 125 you can expect top speed of 115 to 125 km per hour. Talking about the tires, both the bikes have sufficient width tires, providing better riding quality. Both the bikes have 17-inch alloy wheels. R15 V3 has front tire of 100x80 and rear tire of 140x70, whereas KTM RC 125 has front tire of 110x70 and rear tire of 150x60. If we compare better riding stability and road grip between these two bikes, RC 125 has upper hand on this. Both the bikes have rear suspension which is monoshock, but front suspension on R15 V3 is a normal telescopic forks, whereas RC 125 has UST telescopic forks. So these all were the technical differences between these two bikes. Now coming to the second point, which is about the riding comfort, price and mileage. Both the bikes have clip-on handlebar. The sitting position in R15 V3 is more dedicated compared to RC 125. The design of both the bike is top-notch, which gives a premium feel. Both the bikes are track-oriented bikes but lacks in city riding comfort. R15 V3 has a mileage of 40 to 50 km per liter, whereas from RC125 you can expect mileage of 45 to 55 kmpl. Now coming to the most important part, which is the pricing of these two bikes. R15 V3 is priced at Rs 1.39 lakh ex showroom Pune, whereas RC125 is priced at Rs 1.46 lakh ex showroom Pune. So what do you guys think? Do you really think that the price of RC125 justifies the bike's features? And can it compete with R15 V3 in the time to come? That's it from my side, guys. If you like the content of this video, do give it a like button and do subscribe to my channel for more bike and tech related videos. Thank you, guys.